Hello everyone, welcome to my channel again. This is Dr. Furkan Gözükara. I am going to answer a question of my follower student. He was developing a .NET Core 6 MVC application, ASP.NET MVC application, and his application were not working when he published his application on a Windows operating system. I had to debug his application and find out the reason, because when I run his application, it is just running fine on a local host in a debug mode. As you can see like this, it's a simple application. But when we have published it in Windows 10 operating system, it was not working. So first of all, to publish an ASP.NET Core MVC application in a Windows operating system, you have to install turn Windows features on or off, and you need to install ASP.NET 4.8 and Internet Information Services IIS. So an ASP.NET application runs on an IIS server in Windows operating system. Either it can be Windows 10 or it can be Windows Server. Okay, it doesn't matter. After you have installed these, as you can see, Internet Information Services and ASP.NET 4.8, you also need to install ASP.NET Core Runtime Hosting Bundle. You see, there are packages for Windows, macOS, Linux, and your target operating system. For Windows 10, and since we are using ASP.NET Core 6, in this application, we install this one, Windows Hosting Bundle. I have installed both of them, so the application is currently ready to publish. So this student of me has used ASP.NET Core, actually Entity Framework.NET Core migrations. You see, it is here, migrations overview, if you are interested in it. This is code first, then database approach. It generates a migrations folder under your application, as can be seen here. By the way, I will upload all of the source code to the GitHub, and I will also put the links I display on here about migrations and .NET Core runtime. Okay. So this migrations command that you run through, let me show you, command line, developer command prompt, or developer PowerShell, it generates this necessary code in here. And by using this, you see this is auto-generated, it generates your database based on your code. Okay, so these are the code that is written by my student, follower student, and I am showing you how to make it run through this application. So let me show you. It will generate a to-do application, to-do app database, when I run the application first time. Let's run the application. It is running, it is initializing, and let's see. Okay, it is here, as you can see. So when we publish it, why do you think it is not working? Okay, the connection. Oh, we need to reconnect, I think. This is weird, but it's fine. Maybe it is because I don't have the necessary rights. Okay, let's just do something. Yeah, the application is working. Okay. However, when we publish this application, it won't work. By the way, I am annoyed with this problem, so I will just disconnect and reconnect with Windows authentication. Yeah, okay. Actually, I was in another user probably. As you can see, our database is working. There is migrations history. This is used to update your database if you change code. All right, so now let's publish our application and see if it is working or not. This was my student's problem. He uses default settings. As you can see, the connection string is written in appsettings.json file. It is written as server localhost database to do app integrated security true. This works fine when you run in debug mode. However, when we publish it, what will happen? This is the problematic thing. I am opening IIS server and I am going to compose a test website. Okay, I'm going to add a website. I will call it as to do app. Okay, let's generate a folder for it in our init pub folder here, www root new folder to do app. Okay, and I'm going to call it as to do app.com. There is no such, there could be such host, but we will use our local host to do app.com. And okay, oh, this didn't select it. Okay, net pub www root to do up. Okay, so to be able to access to do up.com through my localhost, I need to open and edit hosts file. It is inside Windows, okay, drivers, actually system dot system 32, yes, system 32 folder here, then here drivers folder, here etc folder and hosts file. I will open it with em editor and I will add 127.0.0.1. this is localhost IP, and now it will redirect me to localhost IP when I type to do upcom in my browser. Okay, so we are ready, and now it is time to publish our application. I am going to use publish, and let's see the options. There is release.NET 6, self-contained or framework dependent. It ups to you. You can also select the target operating system. I am selecting Win X64. You see it auto adds the database connection string. And yeah, this is fine. You shouldn't select produce single file. I think it is not working on Windows operating system. I'm not sure. Okay, then let's publish it. Okay, the publish has been completed. Now I will copy and paste files into my generated netpub folder here. Wwroot to do app. Let's copy and paste. Okay, it is here. Now when we open to do app.com, let's see what happens. Okay, as you can see, it is not working, and the reason of this is that when you set your database connection as like this, it will not work in a published environment. This was the reason why our application, why the student's application was not working. And to solve this problem, we need to add a user to our users in security logins, okay, in here. So I am going to generate as a new user as test of user. This will be password. Let's generate a new login. Let's say to do app. This is the name of the login. I will set SQL authentication. I am setting password. I won't enforce password policy, but you can also apply that. And you also need to give it roles. So I think I will give it server admin. This should be sufficient. I'm not sure. You can select all of them as well. There's DB creator. Maybe I will also select it. Okay, or you can select all of them. I will select all of them for tutorial purposes, but you can select only the minimum required one for your application. Now we have a new user, and for this user account to be used, we need to change our settings as, so user ID will be equal to our new username, which is todo app, and the password will be equal to test app user. This is our password. And once we make this, after we make this change, we also need, let's run the application and test it whether it is working or not. First of all, okay, it is working. Okay. And secondly, we need to republish. Okay, when we select all settings, we need to change this string. Okay, save and let's publish. Okay, I will just pause video while publishing. Okay, the republish has been completed. Now I will update the files inside our todo app folder inside www root. Okay, we can just skip in use files. It should be good. And when we refresh our, okay, as you can see, now our local host is working as supposed to be. Now that we have fixed our database connection problem and we are able to publish our website ASP.NET MVC.NET Core application, this should work in .NET Core 3, 5, 6, whatever the version you are using. Currently this application uses, let me show you, properties.NET Core 6, but it should be same in other .NET Core as well. Now I will upload all of this source code into a GitHub folder. Okay, this is our repository that we will publish our source code. So I will open Git bash and I will move to CD desktop, CD. Okay, it was here, I think. Okay. Okay, it's, then we need to add the commands. Okay. Git remote at origin, git remote at origin, okay. Okay. Oh, we have added also the unnecessary files, so to not add them, I will make the necessary changes. You don't need VS folder or object folder. Okay, let's close this. I will just delete the Git and I need to close the application again and inside object, and here I should delete object as well, and I can delete binary as well. Okay, so git at remote origin, git remote origin, Okay. Or let's say initial upload. Okay, it's uploaded to repository. As you can see, the app is here, which it should be same as everything, yes. And when we open the application from SLN, it should just work fine in your computer as well. Make sure that you have generated a user as this, or you need to change it back to localhost authentication as I have shown you previously. Okay, this is all. If you also have questions, please ask me through our Discord server. You can find our Discord server on our channel. Here you see we have official Discord link. You can also see my LinkedIn and the game that I develop. Please also subscribe, and if you join, I appreciate that. Thank you so much for watching. Please make comments, like, subscribe, and hopefully see you later.